Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. I would love it if you clicked that subscribe button and became a member of my MUA squad. It would be awesome to have you here. Thank you so much for checking out this video and this makeup tutorial. But you guys are up close and personal today with me. I'm trying out a bunch of new products. Well, not a bunch of new products, but a few new products today. So I'm excited to use that and whatnot. So let's just get into this video. So I'm going to be doing my foundation possibly off camera or just last in this video. I'm going to start off with eyes, and I'm so excited. If you guys saw my last video, or it's my video before that, I want to say it's either my last video or my video before that, I did get the Kylie Royal Peach palette, so that's what I'm going to be testing out for you guys today. It does come with a brush, so I will be testing out this brush as well, so it's going to be a full-on first impressions video and, you know, makeup tutorial, trying out new things, all the above. So really excited about that. Also, I did get some new brushes, and these are what they look like. They're so pretty. These are gonna be solely for YouTube, just because I'm always constantly washing brushes, and I've always wanted to have just a set of brushes for YouTube purposes. And these came in just in time, and so I was really, really excited about that. My friend actually did send these to me. I'm not getting paid or anything like that. They are Luxe. And they're really, really soft. I was very skeptical of them, but they're like bunny tails. Like one of my coworkers says, they feel like bunny tails. So they're really soft, and I'm really excited to try those out and see how I like them. But those are new. I got a couple of new other things, but let's just go on to the video because I don't want to make this video too long, and yeah. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to be using my Mika Bella eye primer. It's very much loved. It's literally almost empty, so there's that. I may just use my finger for this one. Actually, I'm going to be using the Luxe Large Shader Brush. So I'm going to dip into that a little bit and apply that to the eye. Now, this product is starting to get dry, so I do need to get another eye primer. So let me know what eyeshadow primer you guys like. I'm going to go in with my NYX HD Photogenic Powder. This is in translucent, and I'm just going to go in and use that to set the eye primer just so it doesn't budge or anything like that. And I'm actually going to go in with a Luxe Large Fluff Brush, and I'm just going to just set that all over just so it's going to be easier to blend out my shadows later on. These brushes feel like pillows. Oh my gosh. This brush is so, so soft. I love this brush so far. So now that I have that all set, I'm going to dive into the Kylie Royal Peach Palette. So I'm going to go in with the brush that it does come with. This reminds me a lot of the 217 brush from MAC. It's just like kind of in a way a standard brush. It does come with a mirror as well, which is really nice. Pretty decent sized mirror, so I think I'm going to use that. But I think I'm gonna go in with this shade, and this shade is, let's see, Sandy, I wanna say? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's Sandy. Yeah. So I'm gonna go in with Sandy right here, and I'm gonna take that into the crease. See how this works out. Okay, pretty pigmented. This brush isn't really like anything to write home about. It just feels like a 217 brush, so. There's a decent amount of kickback on this palette. That is something that bothers you. I don't know if I would purchase this. And I did find out that these are magnetic. I'm sure most of you guys know that by now. But these are magnetic, so. There's that. So that's really, really cool. I like that. I do like that because you can take it out of the palette, and if you really want to, you can put it in a Z palette. Make sure it's super blended. I'm gonna go in with the Luxie. This is the tapered blending. I'm just gonna use that to smoke out the product. Just really hope that blend. And this brush is so soft. Now I know everyone's doing like the whole typical orange on top and blue on bottom, but I don't know if I'm going to be doing that today. So next I think, what do I want to go in with? There's so many shades. I don't know. And there's 2, 4, 6. There's about 6 shimmers in this palette, which kind of sucks that there's so many shimmers and there's not a decent, there needs to be a good, like, outer corner shade, like a little bit of a deeper shade. Yeah, that would have been nice. Maybe put a black in there, that would have been nice. Other than that, that's the only thing. The palette does get a little dirty from the kickback. I will say that. Yeah, so let's figure out, what do I want to do? I'm trying to think. I kind of want to dip into this like pinky purple shade right under the royal color, which is called North Star. So I'm thinking I'm gonna dip into that shade. I'm gonna go in with, I don't know if I wanna do this in like a crease area. I think so. So I'm gonna go in with the Luxie eye shading brush and pick up that pinky purple shade. Okay, well, this, we'll say this doesn't have much of a pickup either. Can you see that? Can you even see that? I feel like I might need to put down some concealer. Don't know. I'm gonna go back in with that blending brush, and I think I want to. I do want to put like maybe like an orange of some sort in the above the crease a little bit. So I think I might. I think I might go in with the shade next to Royal, which is peachy. So I'm gonna take a decent amount of peachy. Tap up the access. A lot of fallout. And then I'm just going to run that above. gonna do it like that. Now I'm gonna go in with a little bit deeper in the crease. I feel like I do. I feel like I wanna deepen up the crease a little bit. I'm gonna go in with the Luxie pencil. And I'm gonna go in with cinnamon, which is at the end of this palette right here. Take that, tap that in, tap off the axis, and just place that in the crease. Cinnamon's not that deep. I was expecting this to be a deeper shade. I feel like the cinnamon shade is orange. I feel like the shade peachy is darker than cinnamon for some reason. Peachy seems so much darker than cinnamon. Maybe I'm gonna go in with, what is this? Dupe. That's at the end on the top row. Oh, that's in Dupe, and take that in the crease. I'm gonna take my little old donut and wipe cinnamon off. And then go in with Duke. I will say this mirror in the palette is really, really nice because I'm not even using my makeup mirror. I'm using the mirror in the palette. I feel like the colors are just all blending together, so I would definitely suggest a decent, like, deep shade, because there definitely needs to be a deeper shade in this palette. I really don't think that not having a deep shade works. I'm just gonna blend some more. Once you got that all blended, I'm going to go in with some concealer, and this isn't new, but it's new. So, this is not the NYX Photogenic HD Concealer. I do not like the Photogenic HD Concealer. It's not my favorite. I think it's just too watery. But what I did was, because of this shade was pretty much almost empty, I just took it out and I pretty much DIY'd my own. And I like the LA Girl Pro Concealers, which is what is in here. This is in natural. I don't like the brushes on the Pro Concealers. I love the doe foot on these. So I pretty much just took apart this and put the LA Pro Concealer, LA Girl Pro Concealer in this, so I think that it works out so much easier. So I'm just going to take that and just place that on my lid and kind of in a way carve out my lid. A decent amount of that on. I'm gonna go in with, I'm gonna just go in with the large shader and just carve out the lid. Go in with a more finer brush. This is the concealer brush, so I'm going in. Clean up the line. So now that I have that all primed, I'm going to go back in with North Star and see if that helps a little bit. Okay, that definitely helps a lot. I would definitely suggest putting concealer down first. Or like a white eyeshadow primer, if you have one. I don't. And then using this shade. Purple shade is really, really pretty. Once it's like built up, it's a really, really pretty shade. So, I want to do something. What do I want to do? I really wish there was a darker shade so I can put that in the crease. That's what's really bugging me right now, is that I can't put a darker shade in the crease. I feel like I'm gonna have to stop at this, at least on the top of the eye, because I don't have something to put in the crease. I don't know what shade I should use to put in the crease. I really don't. Kind of want to try out this green yellow shade, which is called Mojito. I don't know. This is just such a hard thing to pull off. Well, first I'm gonna go back in with the taper blending, and I'm gonna go back in with that shade called Sandy, and I'm just going to run that on my lower lash line. So, now that I put Sandy on, I'm gonna go, I kinda wanna try out this blue shade, but I also really wanna try out this green Mojito shade. I'm gonna go back in with that pencil brush. I'm gonna dust that off all as much as that orange as I possibly can. Or maybe I'll go in with the flat shader. I could do both. Flat definer brush, which this is a really, really pretty brush. I'm excited to try this brush out. Should I try out this gold? I kind of want to try out this gold. I'm going to try out this gold shade. I'm going to place that on the bottom lash line, and that one is called Queen Bee. But this shade is gonna look so pretty if it went wet. I really like this brush so far. just, I really want there to be like deeper shade. This makes me so sad that there's not a deep shade in this palette. Don't know. Maybe I'll go in with a little bit of Duke. Place that on the outer corner. Try and deepen it. I just want to keep adding shadows to this lower lash line, I feel. Maybe I'm going to go in with Duchess, which is the shimmer shade right here, and apply that as well. So pretty much I'm just layering shadows. Now, this is definitely a different eye from what I see on YouTube. Everyone's doing like the whole red lid with the blue on the bottom lower lash line, but I decided to try something different. So now I'm gonna go on with some custom lashes that I created. My favorite lash brand is Dodo Lashes. They were only $5, guys. $5 to $12. They range from $5 to $12, and the lashes I have are the D115 lashes, but I did custom them with the Salon Perfect lashes in number, I think it's 16. I think that's the number. I'm not quite sure, but I just customized these lashes and I'm so obsessed with them. So, since I took a little break because I had to charge up my camera battery a little bit, I need to buy another one, but since then I did put foundation on, I did brows and lashes, and I think lashes look great with this look, especially these custom lashes I did with my Dodo lashes and my Simply Beauty, I think that's the brand, Simply Beauty lashes. I love it. Like I said, I do have a small little coupon code for you guys if you guys do want to check out Dodo Lashes. They're my favorite lash brand. One of my favorite lash brands. Like, I love them. I think they are great lashes, and I think these custom lashes look amazing, and I'm obsessed. But, so now I'm going to go in with concealer, and I'm going to go back in with my LA Girl Pro Concealer. This is in Natural. I'm not going to put a bunch on. I'm just going to do a couple of swipes. 2, 3. And I'm just going to, what should I blend it out with? Ooh, I kind of want to try this brush. This is the light concealer brush. So I'm going to blend that out. Just using patting motions as well. I don't want to disturb the under the lower lash line makeup. Patting and blending down. Now this is a pretty light shade. It's just going to be a pretty heavy highlight for me. Blend that out with the finger. Go do the other side. 2, 3. Just 3 swipes is all you need, and blend. brush is so soft. Love this brush. Blending that in. And then use my finger. Get right up in that inner tear duct and just pat away. Now, whatever's left on the brush, I'm gonna take a little bit on my Cupid's bow. What that's gonna do is it's going to pull your lip forward to make them look more full. I'm going to take that concealer again and do a couple of dabs on down the nose. One, two. And I'm just going to tap that out. Pull that down deep. Just really blend that in with my foundation. I really like that. And what's left, just I'm still on the forehead. I'm not going to place any other concealer. Only because I don't like to highlight my forehead that much. Whatever is left, I just take it and just place it on the forehead. Okay. Loving this so far. So now that I have all of that, I'm going to be setting my face with my Smashbox in the shade Light, which actually really isn't that light. It's actually more of a yellow shade, and oh, and this is messy. This is a messy powder, but as you can see, it's more of a yellow shade and it's not that light. I'm gonna go in, this is a large powder brush. And I'm just going to take some of that, try and place that product back into the pan, but as well as use it on my face, and just place where I don't have the concealer. So pretty much the perimeter around my face, or around the concealer. But this is just gonna lock in the foundation that I placed down earlier. Wow, these brushes are so, so soft. Oh my gosh. Now just right here, I'm just going to set that. Only because I didn't put a ton of concealer on my forehead, so I'm just gonna take that across my forehead. I'm in love with this powder. And this is the Smashbox Halo Hydrating Perfecting Powder. And I really like this brush to apply. No bad things so far about these brushes. These brushes are so soft. So next I'm going to take my NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat powder. This is in the shade Tawny. And I'm just going to take the same brush and place that on my neck. And this is a foundation powder. I like putting this on my neck because I don't like taking liquids on my neck. So I just take this and just run this on my neck. But oh my god, this brush places product like a dream. Obsessed. That's just complete. Okay, so next I'm going to set my under eyes. I think I'm gonna go in with the, I'm going with the brush I used before. And this is the large fluff brush. I'm gonna use that to set my under eyes. I'm gonna go in with the NYX powder. This is a translucent powder. And I'm just going to set the under eye with that. Or at least everywhere where I placed the concealer. Just so it doesn't budge. And the nose. Now I didn't have too much concealer on, so it's not a heavy highlight. But don't worry, I am going to be highlighting with a shimmer. So now that I have my face all set and everything, the eyes are finished, my face is set, I am going to go in with my duo from e.l.f. And this is in St. Lucia and the blush and contour shade. The take a decent amount of that blush, tap a back fist, and place it on my cheek. I love Duo Fibers for blush because they don't disperse a ton of product and it helps blend out the blush shade. As you can see, like, it's so pretty. And this duo, once again, this is another super soft brush. Next, I'm gonna go in with the, this is actually a small contouring brush. Gonna go in with the bronzer side now. The contour side. Get a decent amount of that on my brush. Top off the excess and contour. This brush is pretty nice for contouring. Okay, I see you. It sits right in your cheekbone, like right under the cheekbone. It's so cool. Not in your cheekbone, but right under your cheekbone. So nice. To contour that hollow, yeah, this is like the perfect brush for that. Great job, Lexi. Then I'm gonna take that up to the temple. Left. Take my powder brush and just blend a little bit. So next I'm going to go in with highlight, and the highlight shade I am using is my Tried and True Maryland from Drawer Cosmetics. Absolutely love this brush, or this highlighter. I was gonna say brush, highlighter. I'm gonna use, this is another duo fiber. I'm just gonna use that to highlight the cheekbones. Put a decent amount of that on my brush. I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go in with this angled brush, and I'm gonna just take a little bit of this highlighter and take it down the nose. So once you got the highlight on, last step is lips, and my new product for lips I'm going to be using is the Gerard Cosmetics Lip Pencil in Sugar and Spice. Now I'm going to be placing this perimeter of my lip. So these lip liners glide on so well. I'm in love with these lip liners. I think they're really, really nice. They are just as amazing as the Kylie lip liners. They glide on so well. I love them. So lips today, I'm going to go in with one of my favorite lipsticks. It's a lipstick, guys. I'm not using the liquid lipstick. This is, which is almost gone, and I need new ones. And I don't know if this is limited edition or not, which sucks. But this is by Maybelline, so Maybelline, if you are happen to watch this, my favorite shade is Trouble to Use. That's what I'm going to be using, and as you can see, I need more, and I have no idea if they are limited edition or not, because I know they just came out with their matte line, and so I don't know if they took away this line. This line was the In the Buff collection, and I have no idea if they still have that collection out. And if they don't, I'm going to be sad, because as you can see, I'm almost finished. I'll be so sad. I love it. I love this shade so much. And it's so gorgeous. And that is the video of me trying out some of my new makeup that I purchased and got in the mail. And this makeup tutorial that I created with the new makeup. So if you guys did enjoy this makeup tutorial, if you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, so I can do more of these. And if you guys do want to see more looks from the Kylie Royal Peach palette, let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe to my channel if you did just stumble upon my video and you have made it to the end. Be sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. All those are at TobinMUA. And if you end up creating this look, be sure to hashtag MUA squad or MUA troops. I still don't know which one I like more. I like them both, but if you wanna hashtag those, then I will be able to find your work, and I think that would be so much fun. And yeah, I would love to see you guys recreate my look. So definitely hashtag and let me know, tweet me, tag me on Instagram, all that great stuff. But I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.